Making a second one. It's crazy. It's crazy. I got a mic. Crappy webcam, but I got a mic. So. Anyways. Same premise as the last video I did. I'm just going to Google News. Doing stuff that Google is suggesting me. Stuff that I'm interested in. And I'm just going to talk about it. And I'll try to phone. Try to do whatever. See that painting? No, that way. There we go. Painting. I don't know how to control my arm looking at the webcam. It's funky. Anyways, so, first article here is Remembering 2008, the biggest games that turned 10 this year by GameSpot. Let's see what they're saying. Blah, 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 blah. Burnout Paradise. Didn't play it. No More Heroes. Also didn't play it. This is starting out great. Maybe I wasn't playing games 2008. Alright, well, skip. Music industry struggles to shake ugly legacy of sex, drugs, and rock and roll. Why? No, it is an interesting thing to look at, the whole culture of, I guess it just kind of correlated how music just got so integrated with, you know, parties and stuff like that, and other stuff started, you know, was just a natural evolution, so it came into parties, so music and partying and sex and drugs and all that stuff kind of all fused together into this one thing, and I guess, I don't know what they're talking about here. Maybe music industry CBC. Let's see if there's anything else in this article. Okay, so they're just talking about the Me Too movement and how that is involved with how music is starting to change and starting to change its image, which I think would be awesome no matter what. Even if this Me Too stuff wasn't going on, I still think it would be an awesome change just to get the, because right now every pop song that's on there is about, okay, not every, that's overgeneralizing, but I mean a mass majority of it for years has been, you know, sex, drugs, whatever, it's all that stuff that, like, and that dominates it, and it'd be nice just to hear some other pop stuff, because I really do like pop music. I just don't like the pop music they play on the radio. See, there's a difference. There's a lot of pop music that does get played on the radio, which is so weird, just, but that's because of the evolution of, you know, YouTube and Spotify and Google Play and things like that. All these streaming services allow a whole new category of pop music, like AJR, I think their album The Click is my go-to pop album. If I want to listen to a pop album, I go to that, because they do pop, but they don't do pop radio. It's weird, but I don't think they have a song on there that's about a girl or about love or about sex. Like, they have a song about drugs, but they do it in a kind of funny kind of way, and I really like it. I think that is an amazing album. Yeah, definitely worth checking out. AJR, The Click, if you got time, whatever. Alright, let's go back here. Gruesome light novel series Goblin Slayer is about to be in TV anime. There's way too many animes. It's absolutely impossible for me to keep up with all of them. I have, like, my four that I watch consistently. Outside of that, there's not really, I got to, like, past episode 300 on One Piece, and the only reason I made it that far is because people kept saying, it gets better. I gave up on it. I can't, like, and now people are saying, oh, this is when it just starts to get itself together. I'm like, are you kidding? I've watched 300 episodes of the show. I don't know how much further I can go with it. Not saying it's a bad show, it's just not for me. I don't like how there's so many useless episodes. And I like the characters. I like the villains. I like the world. It's cool, but I don't know how many times I can handle watching the same, like, just the same thing over and over and over and over and over again. Like, they don't. The way Dragon Ball Super is doing it right now, and the way they're handling their pacing problem is they have something happen each episode. But with One Piece, for one thing to happen, it takes like so many episodes. And it's so frustrating because you'll be going back between like three different fights, and you'll be going like step one, step one, step one, step two, step two, step two, step three, step three, step three. Instead of just being like, here's the whole first fight, here's the whole second fight, here's the whole third fight, like doing it like that, so that way you can see some progress instead of watching each one progress one at a time. It's so frustrating. But anyways, another Black Panther thing blows away box office with 192 million weekend. That's awesome. Yeah, I'm hearing a lot of new one. I'm seeing it Tuesday, so I'll probably do a little talk about it. Maybe. Who knows? I'm still figuring this. Frankensteining DC Comics. So it's for me. I don't know what that even means. Silicon Valley parents are raising their kids tech-free, and it should be a red flag. Obviously, it's ironic, but I wonder what if there's more to this. Silicon Valley parents can see firsthand, either through living or working in the Bay Area, that technology is potentially harmful to kids. Many parents are now restricting or outright banning screen time for their children. The trend follows a long-standing practice among high-level tech executives who have set limits for their own children for years. This is an installment of Business Insider's Your Brain on App series that investigates how addictive apps can influence behavior. So that's kind of like the bullet points of what this article is. It's interesting. I thought about it before, like, if I had kids eventually, what would I do? Would I let them have a phone early on? Would I let them have a TV in their room? Would I let them have game consoles and things like that? And it's weird because my parents were never very restrictive for me. I had a TV in my room my entire life. I watched any movie I wanted to. It wasn't really, nothing held back. And I don't know, maybe it did cause some introversion, like, ish. I mean, I'm making YouTube videos instead of hanging out with people on a Saturday night, so you know how it is. But yeah, it's hard. It's hard, and it varies person to person. That's another thing about it, is you can have a kid and you give them all the technology and they just know how to maintain it themselves. They know how to discipline themselves. And I mean, some people just have that in them, like, and then some people cannot control themselves. So I don't think it's as easy as a blanket statement. And I mean, very, very few issues are a blanket statement. So yeah, it varies, and it varies. I don't know what to say about it. I'm trying to think, if I had a kid, I would not let them have a TV in their room until they can afford to buy a TV for themselves. Now, not saying they're not gonna be able to use a TV. Oh, my camera's super lagging. Is it gonna catch up? You gonna fix yourself? Camera. Camera. Oh, camera dear. Oh, there we go. It is getting close. Okay. Anyway, sorry. But yeah, I would let them, like, use the TV in the living room, and, I probably would buy them a console just because I want to whip their ass at Mario Kart or something. And just, I would allow that, but I wouldn't allow it in the room until they can afford it. Just so that way they can kind of earn that step, earn that kind of responsibility and self-control. And computer, probably just have a computer that everyone can use. Phone. See, phones is a tough one. Because the reason my parents bought me a phone in the first place was for emergencies. N Didn't really get used much for emergencies. I think I called them a couple times when I missed my bus after school, but is nothing major. I don't know. Phones are tough because nowadays they are becoming more and more and more of a necessity. But they also open up so much when you're young. Because I know I've made a used at like dating apps and whatever when you're not 18 or chat rooms or stuff like that. And you know, there has been people that have manipulated nothing super serious, but I mean people that have, you know, manipulated my emotions just because they can, and it's hard. But you also can't shield your child from the world, 'cause then they're gonna walk into it and be like, whoa. But you also can't throw them into it. It's a balance there. You gotta ease them in. So, I'd probably just get them an iPod or something. I don't know. That's a tough one. It's not many years off, and when I'm blah, 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 word vomit. Is it wrong to try to pick up girls in a dungeon? TV anime returns for second season. That name is so interesting. I looked at that anime a few times. I kind of shy away more from animes that do a lot of fan service. I don't know why. I'm just me might be the Westerner. Oh, fuck me, the Westerner, Westerner in me that kind of just I don't know. It's just. I think with a lot of those shows, I get worried that they're gonna focus too much on the fan service and not the story or the characters or things like that. Seven Deadly Sins kind of did an interesting thing with that, how it fit into this like the story more ish. It was still weird, but they at least made jokes about it, and it wasn't so like just normal. It wasn't just so like, oh, her ass is showing. Oh my God. Wait, that kind of. I think you know what I mean, even though I'm explaining it very poorly. But yeah, I just. Yeah, that's kind of where I stand on that. I don't know. I don't hate it, but I just don't like it when they focus on it too much. I really do. I find it very funny. It's the whole thing is like flipping the script. Obviously, you want to do what people don't expect, and that's what makes something funny. Just taking something in a completely different direction. And I do like it when a girl acts more perverted. I just started watching. What is it called? What is it called? I have to. Don't hate me. Don't hate me. I don't remember names of things. Oh God. Oh God. Gintama. I just started watching Gintama and. There's a girl character in that that is super obsessed with a guy. I mean, obviously other animes have done this, but I mean, for me, it's my kind of first experience. I'm not super into a lot of animes, but yeah, anyways. And I find it interesting that they flip the script like that. And they're, I don't know, I just, you like to see something that isn't, you know, just repeated, repetitive. You don't, no one likes that. If you can't. Okay, I mean, some people can. I'm a person that I can watch a movie maybe up to twice. More than that, if there's like a director's commentary and whatever, but most of the times I can watch a movie like twice if I like it. If I don't like it, blah. If I don't like it, I probably won't even watch it now because I know review scores and I know which people I kind of, you know, usually agree with when it comes to movies and stuff like that. So I usually avoid the. Anyways. Getting off on another tangent. But yeah, I think. What do I think? I don't know. I think random things. There's an elephant over there. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know how to end this. I don't have an intro. I don't have an outro.